What's going on, everybody, and welcome back to another episode of the Book Binge on the King Crusoe YouTube channel. This week is episode 41, back again for another monthly reading wrap-up and TBR video. Now, October was a really crazy month, as I kind of outlined a little bit in the State of Affairs video that released last Tuesday, so 6 days ago from the time this video releases, and I had a pretty great birthday in the middle of the month as well. Thank you to everybody who got me gifts, as I showed off in my book haul video that released on Friday, so just a few days ago. So I don't really have much to say for the intro to this video, just that I did a lot of physical reading this month, like frankly too much of it, so that I wasn't able to work on certain other projects, that and because of some other stuff as well, but we'll get into that a little bit later in this video. For now, I think we ought to just jump right into this and start off with what books I read in October. Now, similar to September, in which I read The Iliad by Homer throughout the entirety of the month, pretty much, while reading a second book alongside it throughout the entire time that I read The Iliad, October was a little bit similar, which I started the month off reading The Odyssey. This wasn't the only book that I started the month off with. Like I said, it was one that I began in October and read all the way through throughout the rest of the month, to the point that today is October 30th when I'm recording this video. I just finished this book this morning while I read other books on the side. It was actually a little bit crazy because I was thinking that I was going to be finishing this tomorrow on Halloween at the time of recording, but then I figured out that I was reading the last couple books quick enough, books 22 and 23, that I was like, might as well just finish the entirety of The Odyssey and read book 24 as well before I read the wrap-up or record the wrap-up video. And I had a really good time with this. I don't think it necessarily blew me away the way that The Iliad blew me away, but still very enjoyable. And in fact, I would probably recommend this to people a little bit easier than I would recommend The Iliad, even though I still recommend everybody read The Iliad because it's a lot more approachable than they think it is. The Odyssey follows a more typical narrative structure in a lot of ways, and that made it very enjoyable. And a lot of iconic moments in Greek mythology, a lot of stories that probably a lot of people who are in any way familiar with Greek mythology are familiar with, appear in this poem, and that was really fun. But since I had already read a graphic novel version of this actually way back in like middle school, I was familiar with the story, and being familiar with a lot of the tales made this less groundbreaking in my mind than I guess The Iliad was, but I still had a great time with it because it's more narrative structure. I think in some ways I enjoyed this more than The Iliad, but in some ways I enjoyed The Iliad more than this. They're both very good. So this was my whole month read for October. But the other book that I began reading alongside The Odyssey, or actually, in fact, I think I might have begun it before The Odyssey because I talked about this quite a bit, or yeah, I'm actually not entirely sure. I'm not going to spend too much time thinking about it. I talked about this a little bit in last month's wrap-up, this being American Psycho by Bret Easton Ellis. I began this a couple days before October even started because I had a few days to be able to get ahead of my reading for the month, which I'm very glad I decided to take the opportunity to take because I've barely been finishing all of my October reads in time. American Psycho really blew me away. It was a book that I was thinking that I would probably not enjoy very much, if at all, because it was sold to me as being a very particular book, or at least the things that I'd heard about it were very particular in terms of tone and style, what it was trying to accomplish, and I would very much agree with those things. It was very particular. The book is very, very difficult to recommend, so to speak, which is something I go into very in-depth with the review that I have coming of this book. I'm actually not sure when the review of it's coming out, so I'm not going to tell you when it's coming out. I think it's in December. Not 100% certain again, so don't quote me on that, but I have a review of this book coming out that will explain more in depth what I mean by it's very impossible to recommend it, but I enjoyed this a heck of a lot. The tone and the style and whatnot were indeed very particular, which is why it's hard to recommend, but I was sold on it like from the very beginning. It just jived with me so much that I couldn't help but love the book, even in the back half with some very grisly and kind of disturbing scenes. So I really enjoyed American Psycho. That was the next book I read. Immediately after American Psycho, I read a couple books that were a little bit shorter. The first of those being Queen Amid Ashes by Christopher Rocchio, a Sun Eater story, which is a novella that takes place after Howling Dark. I enjoyed this, but I think it might possibly be my least favorite Sun Eater story I've read so far. I'll probably go a little bit more in depth on this whenever I have a review of Queen Amid Ashes and other stories. That'll probably come out next year when I've had a chance to read Tales of the the Sun Eater Volume 2. But I'll just s briefly summarize my thoughts on this. For some reason, I just feel like it was simultaneously too short and too long for the story that Rocchio was telling. For whatever reason, what was happening, it's 10 chapters long, but it felt like somewhere between 3 and 5 chapters too long. In the sense that it could have been a very, very good short story, or it was like 5 to 7 chapters too short, in that it could have been a much better novella if it was more akin to the length of The Lesser Devil back there. Because The Lesser Devil was, I believe it was 17 chapters, 170 pages. This was 10 chapters and like 115 pages. I think it, like I said, like in some places it feels a tad bit too long for it. You know, being in the style of like a short story, but also too short and for it to be the style of a novella. I don't know why I felt this way, but that's just kind of my thoughts on it. So, might be my least favorite Sun Eater story of all of the ones that I've read so far, but it was still very good. Even the worst Sun Eater stories are better than a decent chunk of what I've read this year. So, it's not a dig at the story, but probably the least effective for me, but did definitely have me thinking about a couple of the concepts that it was exploring, and was still a very fun read regardless. Next book was another short one, that being Spooky Season Read, The Haunting of Hill House by Shirley Jackson. This is a classic, I think for good reason personally. It seems that amongst the group of people that I was reading this more or less with, there are, you know, dozen or two people who I know who read this relatively recently or who have read it, and it seems the thoughts on this book are somewhat mixed in the sense that a lot of people don't really like the characters too much, which I suppose I can understand, but I didn't really feel the same way as them in that regard. And then a lot of other, yeah, I just think that the reception to this is a little bit more mixed than I was thinking that it would be. I enjoyed myself. It wasn't my favorite thing in the world. It was definitely felt like, not like a period piece, because that's obviously not what it was, but being written in the late 50s, and for the characters and character interactions and even the setting of the story to feel so authentically 1950s to me, as somebody who really enjoyed like Abbott and Costello as a kid. You know, some media at the time. I was really sold on the book, and the few, admittedly few spooky moments were really spooky. To me, I thought they were rather effective. The ending was abrupt, and I enjoyed it. I'm a little bit surprised by how many people didn't love this book, because, I mean, I guess to an extent, I didn't necessarily love it either, but I really enjoyed it regardless. After The Haunting of Hill House, I actually went back and forth between starting the next two of my reads, but then I in fact, on Goodreads, I had actually said marked the next thing that I'm going to talk about as started reading, but then later in the day, I was like, no, I'm not actually starting this yet. So then I put it back onto to read, and then put this other book on currently reading, that being Rebecca. I started Rebecca pretty much, I think it might have even been the same day as I finished The Haunting of Hill House, but if not, then it was the day after. And Rebecca is definitely one that I had some mixed feelings on myself. It felt probably the most archaic of pretty much anything that I've read in the past year, year and a half since I started reading again. And I don't know why. Even like the Iliad and Odyssey, which I guess probably don't feel so archaic because my editions of the Iliad and Odyssey were actually translated like literally just a few years ago. I think my edition of the Iliad was 2015 and Odyssey was 2016, or sorry, 2018 when they were published. I think so that might have something to do with why they didn't feel so archaic, but even the Iliad and Odyssey didn't feel nearly as archaic as this. For whatever reason, this coming out in I think 38, 39, something like that, 1938 or 39, outside of religious texts like the Bible, which I have back up there, this was one of the most archaic feeling books that I've read. And the first like 230 pages out of 380 in my edition were just really slow. I guess they were going a lot more for the tone and the setting of sort of gothic style feeling than they were for plot, and I can understand that, but even so, I wasn't super sold on what was going on. Like, I cared enough about the characters to keep going, but I was reading this book more to get to the twist that I had heard occurred than anything else, and I'm glad that I did though, because the first half of this book is, frankly, it's pretty boring and really slow, but once you get to a dramatic scene that happens about 230 pages in, then it's like, okay, well, I'm hooked on what could be happening with these characters now, and then that goes on for 25 or 30 pages or something, but then the twist happens. And the twist was, it's not even that the twist is super predictable, but it's something that I should have seen coming but just didn't. So I was really shocked by the twist. And especially considering that I knew that a twist occurred in the book, I don't know why I didn't predict what was going to happen, but I didn't somehow. But everything from the twist to the end, so probably the last 125 pages, fantastic, like 5-star reads. But the beginning of it was not amazing for some reason. But I didn't love Rebecca. I didn't hate Rebecca either. It was just kind of middle of the road. I really liked the end of it, but I really did not like the beginning. But yeah, that was the next book that I read in October. And then finally, the last, physical copy of anything that I started reading in October, I began immediately after finishing Rebecca, and that being Tales of the Sun Eater Volume 1. So this is the Lesser Devil and Other Stories. The And Other Stories is what Tales of the Sun Eater Volume 1 is. So far, I've been really enjoying myself. No, I actually have not quite finished yet. You'll see a couple bookmarks in there. That's because that's denoting the start and finish of the current story that I'm on, which is Parliament of Owls. So I have Parliament of Owls and then Pits of Emish. Those are the two stories left that I have to finish in this book. I'm going to be reading Parliament of Owls while this video actually renders after editing it today. So that's what I'll be doing today, and then I'll be able to read Pits of Emish. If not today, then I'll be finishing it tomorrow. So still within the month. But yeah, I've been really enjoying what I've read of this so far. All of the tales have been 4 stars or better, and really, only one of them hasn't been 4.5 stars or better. They've all been really enjoyable to me, doing different stuff that I've been a fan of overall. I would say I really enjoy Tales of the Sun Eater Volume 1. If it keeps up the quality that it's been giving me so far in the 5 stories that I've read, I'm going to be rating Tales of the Sun Eater Volume 1 5 stars probably. So yeah, I've been enjoying this. This was my last physical read for the month. I was coming pretty close to, getting into November and having not finished the Odyssey or Tales of the Sun Eater, and that was not necessarily like spooking me, but it was like stressing me out to some extent, because for whatever reason I'm liking to have my books finished before the start of the next month because of reasons, personal reasons, because I'm a weirdo and I'm willing to admit that. But that was the last physical read for the month. And then, of course, which I mentioned in September, I did start in September. I believe it was in September that I started The Wandering Inn on audiobook on Audible. And I can't remember exactly what percentage I got to last month. I'm just going to go ahead and pull up the file for it to double check just because I can. I got to about 42.5%, so that was actually a lot of that that I got through in September. I continued that in October, but I didn't get nearly as much done because of doing a heck of a lot of physical reading and then a couple other things that I was working on as well. I only got to about 58.5%, so an additional like 16% of the book, which was not that much, unfortunately, but it's not that much of an issue. I'm just taking my time with it, been really enjoying it, even if there are some aspects of it that I don't love so much. But yeah, there's that. Now that we've gone through everything that I did read in October, let's discuss my favorite read of the month. Now, a lot of people who were, chatting with me around the time that I was reading it will probably see this coming from a mile away, American Psycho was probably my favorite read of the month, even though I rated it 4 stars and there are one, potentially two things that I read this month that I would actually rate 5 stars. This is probably my overall favorite read. I explain in the review aspects to American Psycho why I think it's technically 4 stars instead of 5, even though I loved it so much, because I rate my books on a combination of how much I enjoy it and certain elements of the book itself. So there are certain things that go on with this that are just like, I don't think I can justify giving it 5 stars, even though I loved it, because there are some things about it that are really particular. But I loved it. And if you don't want to go with American Psycho as being my more as the best read of the month, because I don't think American Psycho was the best book that I read this month. It was just probably my favorite. I think the Odyssey is probably the next one. And this, out of the two favorite reads of the month between American Psycho and the Odyssey is the one that I would definitely recommend to people. American Psycho is hard to recommend for a lot of reasons. And then we get into the TBR list for November. This section is going to be pretty short because I actually only have one book that I'm going to be reading in November. That is Les Mis by Victor Hugo. Big, chunky book. So, like 1,300 pages, this edition of the book is. I think it's, yeah, like 1,302 pages. So, the reason that I'm only putting this on my TBR list for November, for a couple reasons, I need to give Les Mis time. I don't want to, be starting Les Mis and then going through a bunch of other books at the same time, and then end up with another situation with like War and Peace earlier this year, where I started War and Peace in February, I think, but then I didn't finish it until like July because I would read parts of it and then I would read other stuff in between and whatnot, and it just caused War and Peace to take a lot longer than it needed to. I don't want to do the same thing with Les Mis, especially since Les Mis is part of a read-along this time around with a lot of other people going to be reading it in November and or December. Plus, I'm the reason that the read-along for this book happened at all. Around a year ago at this time, I planned to be able to do a read-along for this book in November and December, and originally it was planned to go a lot longer than that, but then I decided to change scheduling for it. I want to be fully present for the read along of Les Mis since it's my read along and since it's a, bucket list type of book and it's a chonky one. So I want to give it time. It's going to take the entirety of the month as it is. November being 30 days and this book being 1,300 pages, I have to read like 40 to 45 pages a day to get through it. And that's pushing it for me. Like that's still spending 2 to 2.5 hours reading every single day as is. And if I want to get through this is going to have to be the only physical book that I read throughout the entirety of the month. Plus, I have some other things going off on this month that I have to work on, including finishing my current novella project and doing all of the editing for that this month, because like if I'm not done by the end of November with that, I'm going to be very unhappy with myself. Plus, a game that I'm really excited for comes out, I believe, on the 8th, maybe the 9th of this month, that being God of War Ragnarok, so Dad of War 2. I replayed Dad of War in October in anticipation for this release, and I cannot put into words how excited I am for that. I'm going to be playing that game on release. Like, I'm not waiting until after the school semester ends in December or anything like that. No, like, I'm playing that game this month. So, I'm not going to try to burden myself too much more than I need to with any other books that I want to read in November. Or, well, I suppose I can add on as like an addendum to this. I will be continuing the Wandering In on audio, but since that's audio instead of physical reading, it's kind of different subsets of time that I spend on that, when I'm doing chores or getting ready for work or something like that, that I listen to the audiobook. So a little bit of a different situation with that. I can say I can hope to get to 75% done with that. We'll just kind of see what happens. I'm not going to worry too much about it because if I don't get to that point, it's whatever. I'm planning on most likely being able to finish The Wandering Inn Volume 1 in December. That's not stuff that we need to talk about right now. And of course, I still have that continued backlog that I need to catch up on, but probably talk a little bit more about that in the coming year, possibly next month, depending on how certain scheduling things go. So that is the end of this wrap-up and TBR video and this episode of the Book Binge. Thank you guys for watching and sticking around to the end of it. And if you guys haven't watched the State of Affairs for the month, as always, I recommend you go to watch that so you know some of the things that are going on with the channel and the plans that I've got going on. If you haven't watched the book haul video from last Friday, I also recommend watching that. It was a big one, several exciting things on that, a lot of books that I'm really happy to be able to have in my collection for various different reasons. But thank you guys, as always, for all the support. I'll be back again next week with, I'm not 100% sure if I double check right now, though. I believe next week is my full series review and ranking, I guess, of The King Chronicles by Rick Riordan. A little bit of a different video, I guess, one that many of my viewers probably aren't going to watch because they're picky. But after that, I'll actually be reviewing the Iliad in 2 weeks. So, you know, always stick around for whatever videos I've got coming out next because I'm really enjoying doing this whole BookTube thing. Thank you guys again for watching. I'll be back again next week.